Good afternoon and welcome to Rabat in Morocco for the first final of this second World Cup of the ISSF calendar here at this wonderful, glorious location. We have clear blue skies here in Morocco. Temperatures are in the early 20s in terms of Celsius. And we're live for you here from the Club Le Chien de Tir. My name is Rory McAllister, and alongside me is Matt Coutts of the United States. Good afternoon, Matt.
Good afternoon. Pleasure to be here. Thank you for having me on.
Well, you're very welcome in this glorious setting. Now, there's a little bit of wind here, which will make things just all the more interesting for this trap final. But otherwise, apart from a bit of wind, which obviously excites us more as spectators than perhaps if you're out there on the field of play, I would certainly say it's almost perfect conditions here this afternoon, Matt.
I would say so too. I mean, the sun is out, beautiful, it's nice temperature. Yeah, besides the wind, like you said, for the spectators, they're probably going to enjoy it a little bit. Athletes, they're going to have to manage. The wind could play a big part in how the targets fly, the pattern of everything, but these athletes are experienced with it. They're gonna be able to manage, and I'm sure that they're going to be able to do as well as they normally do during the qualification rounds.
So there you can see the conditions, 20 degrees, a little bit of a wind, just 3 meters per second, but plenty good in terms of visibility. As the athletes now just out taking a test fire before we get underway. So if you are joining us on ISSF TV on YouTube, then hello and welcome. If you're on ISSF TV on Facebook, then likewise, good afternoon to you. Local time here in Rabat in Morocco is 3:20, and this final is due to start in 10 minutes' time. We'll get underway with the introductions in just a second. So Italy represented in this final in the form of Jessica Rossi. No introduction needed there for Jessica, has achieved so much over the years in the world of shotgun shooting. Alessandra Pirelli of San Marino also makes the final, as does Augusta Campos Martin of Puerto Rico. Melanie Cousy of France will also line up alongside Ryan Phillips of the United States of America, and Fatima Galvez, who has just made so many finals over the years, representing Spain, completes our six athletes in this trap final. So Matt, any predictions for this trap final we're about to witness?
It would honestly be really hard to give you a prediction. All these women are really capable of taking home the top step of the podium. I mean, Jessica Rossi, Fatima Galvez, I mean, all these, I'm pretty sure they're all Olympians. I don't know about the shooter from France, but I know Fatima, Augusta, and Jessica are all have Olympic experience. Try not to be biased with Ryan, but I mean, Ryan's a really good final shooter. I wouldn't be surprised if she's up there. She's very, very talented when it comes to finals. But so are all the other ladies. So, I mean, we're really just going to have to see at the end of it. It's honestly a toss-up.
But as Matt's saying, there are some world-class names in this final, and Melanie Cousy of France did actually compete at Tokyo. I think she finished 25th from memory. I can check that for you. But 12-gauge shotguns is what's being used in this final, with a maximum weight up to 4 kilos. And the cartridge weight, well, you're allowed 24.5 grams. You are allowed that 0.5 differential. But at the end of the day, most of them come in and certainly are served up in boxes around 24 grams. All of that kind of equipment is checked by equipment control before each final, just to make sure everything is fair and ready to go. And just bringing you some glorious shots above the shotgun range here as the sun beats down on us here in Morocco in early February. There's the coaching lineup. You might see just Matt Coward-Holly of Great Britain just on the end there, who's stepping in as the temporary coach for the moment of Augustus Campos Martin of Puerto Rico. He's actually his fiancée. They're engaged and due to be married in 2025 in Salisbury back in the United Kingdom. So we certainly wish Matt and Augusta happy times in between. Of course, there's the Olympic Games, of course, to take care of in between time, before we get through to the likes of 2025. But for the moment, our focus is very much on this trap final. 279 athletes have come to this World Cup, representing 48 countries. And although there's no quota places available, because I'm sure that will get asked in the comments, it often does. No quota places available for the Paris Olympic Games at this World Cup, but those all-important ranking points are available, and those two are what counts in your life as a professional shotgun shooter. So Jamie Stangroom of Great Britain is our announcer, who's now beginning the announcements. So Fátima Gálvez, representing Spain, first to join us, wearing bib number 6. So Fátima, a gold medalist at the Tokyo Olympic Games in the mixed team. And Marcello Dradi is the coach. So next to come out, representing the United States of America, here's Ryan Phillips. So Ryan's a gold medalist at the World Championships. There's Dwayne Weger, who's the coach. A gold medalist at the World Championships in Changwon 2018 as a trap junior. And a silver medalist in Lima as a junior in 2021. And also a gold medalist at the Junior World Cup in Seoul last year. Here's Melanie Cousy representing France, now 33 years old. Silver medalist from Tucson at the World Cup in the mixed team 2018. Jose Bladas is the coach.
Bib number 3, representing Puerto Rico, it's Augusta Campos Martin.
So here's Augusta Campos Martin of Puerto Rico, 25 years old. Silver medalist at the World Cup in Linato 2022. Also a bronze medalist at the World Cup in Lima. That was in the team event. And there is Matt Coward-Holly, who took a bronze medal in the trap in Tokyo. And I'm sure very much has his sights set on the Olympic Games coming up this summer. So the indispensable Alessandra Pirelli of San Marino, again, has made so many finals over the years. And Luca Di Mari is the coach.
Now with bib number 1 qualifying today in first place, representing Italy, Jessica Rossi.
And the illustrious Jessica Rossi, arguably getting the loudest applause, and takes a wave to the crowd, and once again looks very focused coming into this final. Marco Conti will be the coach for Jessica Rossi today. So just to go through some of the other achievements of Alessandra Pirelli of San Marino, silver medalist in Tokyo in the mixed team, a bronze medalist in Tokyo in the trap competition. Jessica Rossi, meanwhile, of Italy, gold medalist in the trap at the London Olympics. She was 6th in Rio and 8th in Tokyo, but a gold medalist at the World Championships 3 times and 1 as a junior, so you could count that as 4 golds and 3 gold medals at World Cups, 1 including the team event. And there's Yanis Herakleios of Cyprus, who will be our jury member in charge of this final. And just joining him alongside, having a quick chat before they start, this is Marian Carbonaru of Romania. And I've had dinners with Marian over my time. He makes his own home brew. And I can tell you, it's very nice, but it's also very strong. And you certainly know it's on your lips when you try it. So that's how it finished in qualification earlier on. And this is how now they line up. Jessica Rossi of Italy in bib number 1. Alessandra Pirelli of San Marino in bib number 2. Augusta Campos Martin in bib number 3. Melanie Cousy in bib number 4. Ryan Phillips in bib number 5. And Fátima Gálvez in bib number 6. And it's those bib numbers that could become important when it comes to the elimination phases. We'll get up to a total of 25 targets. And that's when we'll have our first elimination in 6th place. And then more eliminations every 5 targets across 30 targets, 35 and 40 targets will decide the bronze medal. And then in trap, we have 10 targets to then decide gold and silver. And it's only at that point, at 50 targets, that we can go to a shoot-off to decide who will take the gold medal. So just one of Jessica Rossi's many achievements, a silver medalist in the trap at the World Championship in Baku last year. And one of the differences as well in trap and skeet is that you can settle into your shot with the shotgun and then take your shot at the randomized position of the trap machine in the bunker. You get two targets off to the right and one down the middle. The red flag in the background signals a miss, and it is just a hit and miss sport. But there's a lot more to it than that, and the man alongside me, Matt Coots, certainly knows there's a lot more to it than just hit and miss.
There is a lot, for sure, without a doubt. I mean, as you can see right now, seems like the only thing going on is a hit and a couple misses. Interesting to see. Had four misses in a row to begin the first pass as Jessica Rossi lines up for her second. Go at it, and now she's 2-2.
And you'll see as well, parts of the shotgun are customizable, and that comes down to individual preference.
They do. Without a doubt. I mean, it really comes down to the shooter, and it comes down to what they want and their likeliness. It could be their build. Like for me, my cheeks are a little bit more out, I guess you could say, so my stock is a little bit higher up, has a little bit higher of a comb. It's all like, it really is. It's really just preference. It's what your body likes. It's what you like. It's what you shoot the best. And every single gun is able to be customized in its own way.
So Ryan Phillips just with her hand in the air, just trying to think, signal to the ref that certainly a problem of some sort. Was it to do with the release of the target? We're just trying to find out.
Yeah, looks like Ryan believed that she hit a target, hit the target that flew out, that the ref called a miss, took time, and the head ref looked at both of the side refs and they both gave a thumbs down, so it looks like it's going to stay a lost target for Ryan.
And almost like the old Roman gladiatorial signals of the thumbs down, it's the last thing you want to be seeing when you're competing in a final such as this. Also, Melanie Cousy had a 2-point deduction because of late arrival to the reporting time. And as Matt was just alluding to a second, it's not just the finals that takes your concentration and your ability. It's the entire day and the days before it with qualification, with reporting time, you've got to turn up on time. There's a whole load of protocol that you have to do before you even take your shots. Now, one of the important things and the differences between trap and skeet, of course, Matt, is the choke down at the other muzzle end of the shotgun.
Yeah, chokes play a big part. Being able to have a different constriction of the pattern of the shell that comes out. Obviously, with trap, you want a tighter choke. Most trap shooters like the improved mod on the bottom and then full on the top, just to give them the most condensed pattern for the shot. Because obviously, with Olympic trap, the targets are going out very fast, very far. But then with skeet, targets are relatively close to you. Most skeet shooters will have a more open choke for their bottom shot. So like maybe like an improved cylinder or even a skeet. But then the second shot, as you know, it's going to be a little bit further away in the doubles pair. So some shooters like to have an improved mod in there. It's really just preference. But for skeet, you really want more of an open choke, something that opens up the pattern faster. Whereas for this, for trap, you want a choke that makes that pattern of the shell really condensed, stays condensed for longer out.
And that's also because of distance as well, because in trap, the target is moving away from you at a rapid speed, as Matt's saying. I've always thought that the easiest way to explain it as well, if you couldn't get it into your head, is like a garden hose, a twister. If you twist it one way, the water opens right out.
Yes.
And if you turn it the other way, it narrows down and becomes a lot harder and smaller. And I think that's probably a good everyday way of thinking about
chokes. I've never thought about it that way, actually.
In terms of, well, welcome to the world of TV commentary.
TV terminology.
We talk about garden hoses over a trap final. So as Matt mentioned earlier, quite a few misses coming in. And do not be fooled, these are absolute tip-top, world-class trap athletes here. This is all down to the conditions, which if you missed the beginning of our program. Temperature's around 20 degrees Celsius. There's about 3 meters per second of wind, but if anything, if the wind feels stronger than that. So five targets each so far. And it's Jessica Rossi of Italy who leads on four targets. And we've got a couple of ties. Fatima Galvez is tied with Ryan Phillips at the moment, both on two targets. Sorry, three targets even. And we now move on to the next five targets in this trap final. So 12 seconds is what's on the shot clock for each athlete. And you can see the speaker and microphone just in front of them there on a little tripod. And that's where they make their call for pull in order to have the target released. And in trap, the sequence is randomized. I mean, there are possible ways of memorizing things, but sort of moving a bit into Rain Man territory with that.
Looks like they're all starting to find their groove again.
Yeah, because it can take some time. And it's not unusual, as Matt's just said, to see some early misses, particularly when it's been a bit of a long and grueling day. I mean, this final has got going at 3:30, about 5 minutes ago. And you've got to think of all the hours that have been taken up with qualification. And then there's the traveling as well. Some athletes don't have to come as far. Matt's come all the way from Houston.
The United States doesn't really get a whole lot of leeway with being able to travel a short distance. I mean, anywhere we go, we really have to travel a decent ways. I know with the competitions in Europe and, I mean, like this one in Africa, a lot of the countries that attend are pretty close. It's probably one flight, maybe two at the max for them. For us, it was four to get here. So took a little bit, but really blessed to be here.
This is one of the joys sometimes of flying out of London in the United Kingdom. You can pretty much go anywhere direct to most places. I do think it's a shame as well. The last ISSF World Cup we had in the States, I think, was Tucson, August 2018 for shotgun. And then the one before that in May was at Fort Benning in Georgia. So as Matt's just said, if you're part of the US team at the moment, you always know that you're getting on a plane. So Jessica Rossi settling in again on seven hits at the moment. And that's a miss. And Alessandra Pirelli of the neighbouring country of San Marino. So many finals between Rossi and Pirelli. And will it be another standoff between these two in this final today? And Melanie Cousy just clipped that target as it came out of the trap. But as long as some dust is seen, then that's what counts as a hit. And Galvez took hardly any time there at all, less than a second to turn that target into dust. So So if you are just joining us, then welcome along to the World Cup here in Rabat, Morocco, the second ISSF World Cup of the calendar year so far. No quota places available at this World Cup, but those all important ranking points are at stake. And of course, the chance just to complete at world level and try and go home with a medal. So each athlete has now fired at 10 targets, and Jessica Rossi led after 5 and continues to do so. She's on a total of 8 with only 2 misses so far for the Italian. And then Alessandra Pirelli of San Marino just 1 hit behind on 7 hits so far. So that's how it was after 5. Now the scoreboard adjusted after 10. It's the Italian that still leads the way, and 3 other athletes tied for 7 hits. And then Ryan Phillips of the United States in 5th place on 6 hits. And Augusta Campos Martin is in 6th place as it stands.
And I mean, with 15 targets left, you still a lot of room for a lot of lead changes.
Yeah, as Matt's saying, there's still some distance to go all the way to the end, but it's around about now that you've got the eliminations on your mind, because it's coming up over the next 15 targets between 10 and 25. And you'll just see as well, in shotgun shooting, the differentials in terms of glasses and also visors or caps and also blinders at the side. And that's just, again, down to individual preference, Matt.
It is. Majority of shooters that you see will wear a hat. I mean, it's just something to keep the sun out of your face. Some wear it just because, I mean, it's part of their routine. Like for me, like if... I don't know the last time I've shot without a hat. I would probably feel pretty naked without a hat. So that's something that like I have as preference. I mean, glasses is a huge, huge part. I mean, you want to be able to see these targets as clear as you can, as well as you can on any given day. So it's very important. The color lenses that you have plays a huge part. The background plays a huge part. The lighting. So, I mean, it's big. It really is. It might not seem like it to... I guess you could say people who don't shoot, but I mean, once you get an understanding about it, I mean, you'll know it's a huge part.
It is. It's massive. And I think for those of you who are watching, who have never shot, imagine when you're perhaps on a boat or looking at water and the sun is reflecting down on the water and you put your sunglasses on, it just takes that sting away from your eyes. And when you do wear these glasses, like you're seeing with our athletes in front of us, it's incredible how the target becomes so much more visible. And as Matt was saying, if the conditions change or the daylight changes, it's not unusual to see a shooter switch glasses in order to improve their vision of the clays.
It's not unusual at all. I mean, me, for my preference, I like to have 2 lenses on me at all times, at least. The ones that I'm wearing, the ones that I have to start around, and then ones on top of my hat. And that's just because, I mean, lighting can change throughout a round at any given time. And so I'll usually have a lighter lens on and a darker lens on top of my head, or vice versa, just depending on how the lighting changes.
And I think Pirelli just pausing there and taking a longer look before she pulled her shotgun down. I think she thought she'd hit it. It was called as a miss. And for Alessandra Pirelli, it just means that Jessica Rossi now creeps 2 targets in front. Rossi, the Italian, still leading on 12 hits so far. Jessica Rossi's looking so good this afternoon. 13 out of 15. And now just one to go from Fatima Galvez, just before we have another slight break in this final as we move to the next round. So that's 15 targets down, and it's still Jessica Rossi of Italy who leads the way on 13 hits. She's only missed two targets so far, an incredible performance so far from the three-time world champion, and well, a four-time world champion if you count her junior world championship gold medal back in 2007. And Jessica Rossi just recently turned 32 years old and has already achieved so much. Meanwhile, here's 35-year-old Alessandra Pirelli of San Marino, world ranking number 5 at the moment. And as Matt was saying at the beginning of the program, so many athletes of these six with Olympic pedigree and Olympic experience. Fitness these days plays such a big part as well in the world of shotgun shooting, because fatigue can kick in as well. Yes, it's lovely being here in the sunshine. We always want to be in the sun, most of us. But at the same time, Matt, it's something you've got to consider.
Fatigue is a huge thing in shooting. And it's why it's so important just to stay hydrated, stay on top of your diet. Make sure you're at least somewhat physically fit, I would like to say. Because after 4 days of shooting, you're going to be tired. And so it's really important to make sure that you're up to the, I guess, level of fitness that you want to be.
And it's the mental fatigue as well. It's not just physical. It's both sides.
Everyone says that shooting is 90% mental, 10% physical. I mean, this game is so mentally draining in so many ways, and it's so important to have your mental game on point, because I mean, one thing goes wrong, and if your mind goes to the wrong thing or a negative thought, just that one negative thought can just completely derail you. And I mean, it's important. It's important to have that mental stamina. I know a lot of these athletes do. A lot of these athletes, like I said, have been to the Olympics. They know what it takes to be world-class athletes. And in order to do that, you need to have that mental fortitude. Pirelli picks up her 14th hit. Kuzi's trying to get back on track here after two misses in a row. 4th is not able to.
Yeah, that's 3 misses over those last 3 targets. And as Matt's saying, the reason, I mean, obviously you don't want to miss in a trap final, but at this stage as well, as we creep ever so close to the first elimination phase, that'll be after 25 targets. Melanie Kuzi at the moment certainly won't want to miss too many more, because it can become a mathematical impossibility sometimes pretty soon in shotgun shooting, that you're just unable to move on to the next stage of the final if you don't get enough hits compared to what the other athletes have scored. And of course, that's probably a very obvious statement.
And I think she has that two or three point deduction. I think it was 2 point deduction for missing the reporting time. So would that mean she actually has 9 right now, or now 10? I don't know if they're going to subtract. I don't know if they're subtracting that number from that she has now.
So Jessica Rossi completes her round on 17 hits, only missed 3 so far. There's just that one in the middle of those 5. Pirelli, meanwhile, can close the gap, and does so by one, so he's only one hit behind. Campos Martin with a miss there on 13 hits. So once we get to 20 targets from each athlete, then we're able to work out what their maximum total is. So Melanie Cousy with another 5 would be 18, minus 2 would be 16. So it's looking highly likely that Melanie Cousy could be leaving this final. So 20 targets have now been fired at by each athlete. If you are just joining us, then welcome along to ISSF TV. This is the first final of the Rabat Morocco ISSF World Cup, the second of the ISSF calendar of 2024 in this Olympic year. And Jessica Rossi has been leading the way since the very start. Now just one target in front of Alessandra Pirelli of San Marino. Meanwhile, still got a tie between Ryan Phillips and Fatima Galvez. Augusta Campos Martin also tied with Melanie Cousy of France. But Melanie Cousy does have that 2-point deduction for missing the reporting time earlier this afternoon. So that's a miss for Jessica Rossi. Now, Pirelli has a chance to go level. This is crucial. And does so. No bleep, no red flag. That's a hit. Campos Martin, meanwhile, with a hit. So this is where the bib numbers could come into play as well once we move to the elimination phase. And as you can see on your screen, once we get to 25 targets, that's when we say goodbye to sixth place. So Melanie Cousy with another 4 targets will get up to 18. Minus 2 is 16. So it's all eyes really on Campos Martin and Ryan Phillips in terms of what's going to happen between these three athletes who are all firing in a row at the moment. And these days, Matt, as well, apart from the travelling, which, you know, you've said in took 4 flights to get you here to Morocco.
It did.
What would you say your sort of top 3 challenges as a trap shooter in today's era?
I'd say finding a decent amount of matches in the States to compete in. USA Shooting only really has 2 matches a year, maybe 3 if you're a junior, if you want to include the Junior Olympics. So, I mean, it's kind of hard to find competitions in the U.S. There's a good amount, but I mean, not a lot of people are able to get to them. So I'd say that's something. Staying consistent is another thing in trap. I mean, trap is so hard. I mean, it's so demanding in a lot of ways. So being able to stay consistent is something that every trap shooter might struggle with at some point and most likely will. So I could say that's probably number 2. Number 3.
Doing this job.
I'd probably say making sure that you don't get burnt out. I mean, obviously, you know, if you do something too much for a long period of time, I mean, after a little bit, it could just get a little tiring.
And your body tells you, doesn't it?
Your body tells you. Your mind tells you. I had that experience this past summer after World Championships in Korea. I was shooting all, basically since the beginning of the year, almost every week until the end of July. So after World Championships in Korea was done, I put my gun away for about a month and a half, didn't even look at it, and I'll tell you what, it was very well needed. So, yeah, I'd say those are my top 3.
Yeah, this isn't like shooting for teddy bears at the fun fair.
It is not at all.
So Melanie Cousy of France takes another hit, and this is an impressive streak of hits over the last four targets. Ryan Phillips of the United States also with a hit. Here goes Fatima Galvez trying to keep some pressure on the front two at the moment, which is Jessica Rossi, who'll be keen to hit this one and try and keep the gap between herself and Alessandra Playerly, the neighbouring country, San Marino. There's been so many battles with Playerly and Rossi over the years. So Melanie Cousy, if she hits this, has a 2-point deduction, so we'll finish on a total of 16. And as we guessed a few moments ago, we'll be leaving us in sixth place in this final. And that's a great shot from Fatima Galvez as that target just flew out and off to the right. So 25 targets down, and Menli Cousy, despite not having the lowest total, because she had 18 hits, but with a 2-point deduction, takes her down to 16. And Menli Cousy of France takes a seat now to watch the rest of this final, is congratulated by the other coaches. And that's Jose Bladas, who's their coach, who I'm sure was hoping for better things today, but it just wasn't meant to be. And when you start a trap final at this level with a 2-point deduction, you've already got an awful lot to do. So there is confirmed on your screens. Menli Cousy of France leaves in sixth place in this women's trap final. Jessica Rossi of Italy, meanwhile, continues to lead, but it is a slender lead. It's only by one target.
Yeah, I'd say this is pretty close. This is a pretty close final. 21, 20, 18, and 2 19s. I mean, a lot can happen over five targets. It's really just going to depend on who slips up and who doesn't at this point.
And as Matt's saying, this is when it really gets serious now. I mean, it's serious from the start, but once the elimination starts, every five targets now, there's another elimination that comes along. So Ryan Phillips, who's the youngest in this final at 20 years old. Gold medal at the Junior World Cup in Seoul last year, 2023. And also has world championship experience as well. As a junior, that was in Changwon in 2018. I remember that world championship so vividly. It's been one of my favorites over the years. Oh, and a miss from Pirelli. Once again, she takes a long look as that target flies off to live another happy life somewhere. And that's the second time that's happened to Pirelli in this final, where there's been a big gasp and she's been pretty sure she got close, but at the same time, the dust in the sky says it all as to whether or not the target was clipped. Pirelli rectifies that last miss with a hit this time. And once again, is two hits behind Jessica Rossi. Great shot from Ryan Phillips of the United States, just as that target started to move off and veer to the right. The wind conditions, of course, is something everybody's having to deal with. Wind was measured at 3 meters per second, but it does feel a little breezier than that, to be honest. So let's have a look at some of these totals. So Jessica Rossi can have a maximum total of 26. Pirelli, if she hits this, will get up to 23, a possible 24. Campos Martin can reach 23. Ryan Phillips, a maximum of 24 is available. And Fatima Galvez, a total of 23. So that's where these bib numbers come into place, because at this stage, if there is a tie, it is the athlete with the lowest bib number in terms of starting position that will leave this final. And that's where sometimes in shotgun shooting things get confusing, because you say the lowest bib number, but actually that's bib number 6, which is the highest number.
The bib numbers can play a big part in this. It's a really bad feeling to get bibbed out, especially if you and the person next to you tie. That's why qualification's so important. I mean, it's really important to do well in qualification, obviously get a higher bib number. So if you do tie with someone in the final, you're not the one getting, you know, on the unlucky side of things and having to get bibbed out. Yeah, it looks like...
So Ryan Phillips just about to take a shot, but as Matt was just saying, Augusta Campos Martin with a yellow card.
I don't know if that was a time violation or something.
So Fatima Galvez on 22 can get up to a possible 23. And it means with that shot, Campos Martin is now on 22. So if Fatima Galvez takes this final hit, it means Galvez survives into the next stage of this final and Campos Martin will be leaving us.
So ladies and gentlemen, fifth place.
And that's a hit from Fatima Galvez. So on 22 targets, representing Puerto Rico, Augusta Campos Martin will leave in fifth place. And there's Yanis Herakleios, who is the jury member in charge. That's Matt Coward-Holly of Great Britain, who's just acting as temporary coach at the moment for Augusta. And they are actually engaged to be married. And clearly there's a dispute here.
Looks like there's a disagreement going on for sure.
This is a hard situation for Augusta Campos Martin, also for Matt Coward-Holly as well. His body language says that something certainly has gone on that they weren't happy about. It's more than likely as well the yellow card towards the end of Campos Martin's campaign in this final. So the world of shotgun shooting, it just moves on. And Jessica Rossi opens this round with a hit up to 27. Pirelli still two hits behind. And Ryan Phillips certainly isn't out of this final yet, and certainly in a hunt for a medal. He's now tied with Pirelli. Fatima Galvez, meanwhile, really is the one who has the most pressure stacked on her, only at 24 hits. Again, being eliminated after 35 targets in fourth, you leave without a medal. That's really cruel as well, Matt, because 125 targets for qualification. You then make the final, get all the way just towards the end, and leave without a medal.
Yeah, it's a hard pill to swallow, for sure. I've been there a couple of times. Sometimes you almost wish you just didn't even make the final than finishing in fourth. I mean, it's a really hard pill to swallow, but still, fourth place is... Nothing to be ashamed of.
And it's all part and parcel of the world of shotgun shooting, isn't it? And how you deal with that and how you move forward. And it's only a mistake if you just leave it at that. If you learn from it, then you can turn that into positive steps for the next competition.
Extremely true. It's all about what you make of it. You can let it beat you down, or you can grow from it.
So Jessica Rossi with another hit has a maximum total available of 31 if she was to hit the next target. Pirelli, meanwhile, now on 28. Ryan Phillips with two more hits can also get up to 28, as can Fatima Galvez. So this, I think it was shaping up for a very interesting elimination process in a few moments' time.
Yeah, this next target is huge, especially for Ryan and Fatima.
Great shooting from Jessica Rossi. Just slaps that empty cartridge away. It's been so focused and continues to lead. So Ryan Phillips, that's all she can do at the moment. A total of 28. Now just got to watch to see what happens with Fatima Galvez. But Galvez does indeed hit that target, but leaves the final in fourth place. Because after that shot from Ryan Phillips, she knew that's all she could do and knew she'd be safe, even if Fatima Galvez did make the hit, which she did because of bib number. And even when there's a tie between two athletes at this stage, the lowest bib number will leave the final. And as Matt was saying earlier, it's time now for Fatima Galvez in fourth place to be bibbed out. Jessica Rossi of Italy continues to lead. 31 hits, two in front of Alessandra Pirelli. And here is Rossi. So focused. Was 32 years old last month. And when you look at her record and CV or resume, as it's sometimes called around the world, what she's achieved is just incredible. So Ryan Phillips now, if she's to improve on her medal position, she's guaranteed at least a bronze at the moment. She'll be hoping that Jessica Rossi or Alessandra Pirelli start to miss targets, but from what we've seen so far in this final, that's looking highly unlikely. But I have seen finals where if you just keep shooting, keep hitting, sometimes it can swing your way. And there's a miss. There we are, from Jessica Rossi. So Pirelli now has a chance to close the gap. And just missed that target underneath it. I think it just came out of the trap and was just too high. And Pirelli of San Marino remains two targets and two hits behind Jessica Rossi of Italy. Mm. And that's another miss from Jessica Rossi. We were just saying a few seconds ago, it can happen. The misses can come in. And Pirelli, meanwhile, will know now that she's one behind Jessica Rossi. Meanwhile, Ryan Phillips, it's not over yet for the American. Now tied with Pirelli, both on 31. And if it was to stay this way, if Ryan Phillips and Pirelli were tied, obviously there's still two targets to go, but Phillips would pick up the bronze by virtue of the lower bib number, wearing bib number 5. So the silver and bronze medal is now between these two athletes, and Pirelli blows a sigh of relief. That's a miss from Ryan Phillips of the United States. So it's going to be a bronze medal no matter what happens for the American, because even if she was to tie with Pirelli, the bronze medal will be decided on bib number. Jessica Rossi, at least with two hits, just removes her ear defenders. I think just feeling the heat here in Morocco, particularly if you're from a country that doesn't have this kind of weather at this time of year, and if you haven't been training in these kind of conditions over the winter, and of course it can affect. So the bronze medal is now decided, represented the United States of America. 20-year-old Ryan Phillips who was the youngest athlete in this final. Big smile as well as Dwayne Wager. It's a high five for the Americans. And it's a bronze medal, and it's the first medal of this World Cup here in Rabat in Morocco. So once again, it's a battle between Jessica Rossi of Italy and Alessandra Pirelli of San Marino. There are two targets in between these two. Jessica Rossi over the last five missed two and hit three. Rossi now knows that another gold medal could be hers. But we now have 10 targets to decide gold and silver. And this is at the only stage where this final can go to a shoot-off if they are tied after 50 targets. Matt, I'm not surprised to see these two as the final two.
I'm not either. I kind of had a hunch that Jessica Rossi and Alessandra Pirelli will be somewhere in the top three. And here we are. But no, super excited for Ryan. Last year, actually, one of our American shooters, Rachel Tozier, took bronze here as well. So it's 2 years in a row. Bronze U.S. women. Really happy for Ryan, her first open medal.
So Rossi with a hit. Three in front as it stands with Pirelli now to shoot. And that's a miss. Oh, painful. So Rossi with a hit up to 37 and has seven targets remaining. Pirelli, meanwhile, now needs just to keep the pressure on, but that's another miss. So now slips to 33 and slips to a gap of four targets between these two athletes. Crucial shot for Alessandra Pirelli, slaps the cartridge away, takes a big blow of breath as well, and knows that this gold medal is slipping away from her grasp.
I mean, and that just shows, what we said earlier, how fast everything can change. I mean, they were, two targets apart from each other, one target apart from each other about 5 minutes ago, and now...
With five to go. That's right, and the best that can happen is a draw here for Pirelli, because five hits would take up to 38.
And that's it
now. It's decided that Jessica Rossi adds another ISSF gold medal to her collection. So that'll be five World Cup gold medals for Jessica Rossi, three in individual events and one in the team. So I often wonder what goes through athletes' minds at this stage as well, whenever things are decided, because
now
with that 40 and the crowd applaud as well, they know now that Jessica Rossi is absolutely confirmed as the gold medalist.
It's an amazing feeling. It's an amazing, amazing feeling.
And how do you compose yourself even like this? Rossi still has four shots to go.
I mean, really just, you have it in the bag. You know you're shooting well. And honestly, at this point, you kind of want it to be over. So, kind of what's pushing you forward.
And of course, you just keep going as if you haven't won at all.
That's another big thing. I mean, you have to keep that mindset as if you're still competing with the six other athletes, because, I mean, once it gets down to you and one other person, you can start to become a little lackadaisical mentally, and you don't want that to happen. So it's just important to keep the same mental fortitude the entire time.
Because it's all about these patterns as well, isn't it? And patterns of behavior and patterns of feeling and recognizing those experiences. Because, you know, for want of a better term, really, Jessica Rossi could just deliberately miss each shot, knowing that it's in the bag. And that would be a little reckless.
That would be.
Because you have to carry all those emotions and physicalities through to the next competition and in your performance so that you can call on that experience the next time you're in a situation like this where maybe you are still battling it out in these final stages.
Oh, yeah. It's the sports psychology part of the game.
Which is massive these days.
Huge. Jessica Rossi, last shot. It's a miss.
But she smiles. She knows. It doesn't really matter. I think she looks back to Marco Conti, the coach, just to say sorry. Meanwhile, Alessandra Pirelli, what a strong finish. 5 out of 5. But the gold medalist is confirmed. And Jessica Rossi of Italy now adds another gold medal to the 4 she already has from ISSF World Cups. Adds that also to a collection of gold medals from World Championships. Also won World Championship Junior World Cup. So we'll get a word with Jessica in just a second and an interview for you. Meanwhile, huge congratulations also to Alessandra Pirelli of San Marino with a silver medal. Once again, a battle with Jessica Rossi to decide who would take gold and silver.
The bronze medal representing United States of America goes to Ryan Phillips.
And Jamie Stangroom of Great Britain just makes the official announcements now. The bronze medalist representing the United States is Ryan Phillips.
Representing San Marino goes to Alessandra Pirelli.
Now, big smiles and a punch of the air from Alessandra Pirelli of San Marino. I think there was just nothing she could do today against this illustrious shotgun trap shooter. Once again, Jessica Rossi. And kisses her shotgun, rightly so, raises it up above her head. And once again, the familiar scene of Jessica Rossi as a gold medalist and the shotgun raised above her head. What a moment for the Italian. It's another ISSF World Cup gold medal. It's another silver medal for Alessandra Pirelli. And the first medal that was awarded of this World Cup went to the United States of America. 20-year-old Ryan Phillips is there, congratulated now by Luciano Rossi, the president of the ISSF. And we'll just try to get a word on ISSF TV with the medalists in this trap women's final. So we'll see you in a few moments' time. Also, coming up in 45 minutes is the start of the trap men's final. That's due to start here at 5 p.m. local time here in Rabat. But for the moment, we'll be back in a few seconds with some interviews for you from myself, Rory McAllister, and also from Matt Coutts.
I'll be back.
We'll see you in a few moments. Thank you.
Good afternoon and welcome back to ISSF TV. After the conclusion of that World Cup final, the second one of this year so far in 2024, this Olympic year here, we're celebrating not only just the world of shooting sport, but also another win for Jessica Rossi. Once again, Jessica, you and I are talking about you taking another gold medal. How are you feeling right now?
Sì, sono molto soddisfatta. Questa è una stagione importante. L'obiettivo è a luglio, che è quello di Parigi. Però questo qui era un passo importante per concretizzare il lavoro. Quindi vuol dire che stiamo facendo un ottimo allenamento e questo è un ottimo punto di partenza per proseguire la strada per Parigi.
Non mi ricordo più niente. She said that she is very happy. This is an important step before Paris, and she started very well this year, and she improved a lot for the next step going to Paris, the road for Paris.
Now this is it. We mentioned the road to Paris just a few seconds ago. So going back to London 2012 with the gold medal, then Rio and Tokyo with the eighth place, it didn't quite work out for you. But you look focused to me, Jessica. You look like you're absolutely determined this year to go home with a medal from Paris.
L'obiettivo è quello, ci stiamo lavorando, però con calma, un passo alla volta e rimaniamo concentrati sull'allenamento per arrivare pronti. Poi quello che verrà si vedrà.
Do you know how many medals you've taken over your career?
Quante medaglie you hai vinto?
In Coppa del Mondo? Ah, non lo so.
I don't know. Too many. Yeah. Well, I think one Italian word I think that would sum up your performance today. Bellissimo.
Bellissimo. Grazie.
Arrivederci. Thank you, Jessica. Bravo. Jessica Rossi, once again a gold medalist here in Rabat in Morocco. So once again, it's another medal for Alessandra Pirelli of San Marino. Alessandra, we've met many times. Here we are again talking about a medal. It was another battle with Jessica Rossi. Are you just getting a little bit sick of Jessica Rossi in your life?
Hai capito cosa?
No.
Allora, ha detto, un'altra volta vi siete trovate insieme a combattere, quindi un'altra volta che tu ti ritrovi a fare... E voi vi siete incontrate parecchie volte.
I think that's a yes.
Beh, è un piacere trovarmi in pedana con Jessica, quindi vuol dire che stiamo lavorando bene e sono molto soddisfatta. Insomma, con Jessica abbiamo fatto i centri CAS insieme, quindi è un piacere condividerci qui sulle pedane.
She said that it's a very big pleasure for her to battle with Jessica, against Jessica, because she starts together with the same CAS, the Center of Aviament, to the shooting, no? So for her is an honor, and she said that this is the reason why they are working very well on, yes.
Well, it's not always silver for you. Sometimes, of course, it is a gold medal. Just wasn't to be today. There was a few shots in the middle part of that trap final where you took a long pause because I think you thought you'd hit them, but again, it's just with the wind and the situation today, they were both misses.
Sì, c'erano stati molti piattelli sbagliati, la situazione era un po' all'inizio un po' complicata.
Sì, personalmente non riuscivo a vedere partire il sinistro, è proprio una cosa di visuale, non partivo, dopo mi muovevo tanto e poi mi sono concentrata, mi sono chiusa e mi sono goduta la finale.
She cannot see the left, the beginning, but after she concentrate and she love her final at the end.
Well, it's great to have a rivalry between yourself and Jessica Rossi once again. It's what keeps everything alive in the world of trap shooting. Well done, Alessandra, and I'm sure we'll see you again on a podium.
Confinta di vederti ancora sul podio. Ha detto che hai lavorato molto bene.
Ci voglio andare di nuovo su quel podio. Si sta bene, mi piace.
She wants to go again on the podium. She stay very well on.
Well, it's another silver medal. Well done. Congratulations. Andra Salaparelli of San Marino with a silver medal here in Rabat in Morocco. Next, the bronze medalist from the United States. So back once again with another medalist here in Rabat in Morocco of the second World Cup of the ISSF so far in this very important Olympic year 2024. The first medal, it was bronze. It went to the United States of America, the youngest competitor in the final. You must be delighted, Ryan.
Yes, I am. I've made a final before, but I've never medaled at an open competition, so I'm very excited.
And it was great to see the traditional American high five from yourself and Dwayne Wege, your coach. What did Dwayne say to you just as you approached the seats?
I believe he said, there you go, you got it.
Good job.
Yes.
Yeah, I mean.
Just, you got it, there you go.
So what's next for you?
Hopefully I'll be going to CAT Games in the Dominican Republic, but otherwise it's back to college for me.
Well, that's a nice place, isn't it, the Dominican Republic. So what are you studying at the moment at college?
I'm a communication major right now.
So you could get into worlds like this and into the media and be organising us and helping us. So there's a career for you if perhaps shooting was to nosedive. I don't think it's going to for you. So who do you think's watching back home in the United States?
Definitely my mom. I know she is. She's already.
What's her name?
Jody.
Jody, hello.
She watches all of my finals when she can't be there. And then all of her friends who happen to be around, they join her in cheering me on from afar.
And whereabouts in the States are you from?
Texas.
Excellent. Okay, so you're used to heat like this then?
Yes, very much so.
Well, amazingly, today it wasn't Houston, we have a problem. It was Houston, we have a bronze medal. Ryan Phillips of the United States of America, the bronze medalist here in the ISSF World Cup in Rabat. Coming up for you, the trap men's final starts at 5 o'clock local time right here in Morocco. We'll see you in a few moments.